Don't look to be a hero, never thought of a hero. I have to say this, that any man wearing a pair of pants that calls himself a man would have automatically done the same thing.
But the fact is, Al is the one who did it, at the risk of his own life. So in the eyes of many, he is a hero, witnessed by all the honors and awards he's received, including the highest, gifts from the White House, a phone conversation, and a letter from President Reagan. But amid all of this, he remains a modest man.
If somebody is falling or somebody is in danger, automatically you go to help them. You don't think of your life, you don't think of anything. I never thought of the gun. The gun was the farthest away from my mind. But after the flame, I knew I had
to fight. Dr. Hinckley, you were yelling, kill him, kill him. Were you at all?
If the other party given a nine, a tooth for a tooth, yes. Very much.
In his letter, President Reagan thanked him by saying, you responded in a manner that many individuals half your size would find difficult, and to a danger few people ever know.
So even at 5'2", he might be small in stature, but when it comes to courage, he towers over most of us. For TV5 Eyewitness News, this is Jenny Krim reporting.
For Alfred Antonucci, fame came by quirk of fate. Al wanted to get a look at the president, but when shots were fired, he grabbed the gunman, John Hinckley Jr.
After the first shot and I saw the flame, I knew I had to break the aim of fire.
Afterwards, there were awards for bravery. People called him a hero, but Al would not hear of that. Nope, to Alfred Antonucci, helping out was a way of life that went back to his boyhood days here on Cleveland's Hudson Street. For that helpfulness, his pals rewarded him with the affectionate nickname of Jeep, a nickname that was to stick with him the rest of his life. Later, as an official with the Carpenters Union, Jeep Antonucci would help a guy find work or build a friend's house for free.
If you needed some type of help, you would go to see Jeep, and Jeep would help you. This incident in Washington, that was probably the top off of a man's life.
Ironically, it may also have hastened the end of his life. The stress of the shooting and the interrogation that followed triggered Al's first bout with heart trouble. He bounced back, though. These pictures were taken with Maureen Reagan on April 27th. Those irregular heartbeats returned just over a week ago, and Mr. Antonucci was hospitalized here at Marymount in a coma. His family was told there was little hope for recovery.
Everywhere he went, he touched someone else's life, and I know in my own heart that he touched a lot of people's lives. My father will be remembered for that. I rest assured of that.
Steve Craig, TV5 Eyewitness News.